Tell us about the Utah Arts Council, how you got involved, and what the rewards are there.
The Utah Arts Council is officially the Division of Arts and Museums. It's a state agency. And I got that job almost right out of college. I moved away for a little while, and then I heard about a job opening there in the visual arts program. And it's one of those things that just...
What did you study in college?
I studied art history.
So you were qualified to...
I was qualified, yes. And it was... One of those things where you study art history and people ask you, what are you going to do with that? You kind of think, I don't know, manage a gap or something. You know, you really have no lofty goals with your bachelor's
degree. It wasn't ambition.
Degree.
It was love of
it
art.
Was, yeah, yeah, it's just I wanted to love college and I wanted to love what I studied. And so that's why I chose what I did. And you have ideas of what kind of job you want in your head. But this was just the job I never knew I always wanted. And
where'd you get your degree?
BYU. Mm-hmm. BYU. I studied art history here. And so for the Utah Arts Council, I manage a gallery and administer competitions and whatever else they ask me to do. I work with great people who all have a deep passion for the arts, and you're in an educational environment, so you're learning new things all the time. So it's a great job. One of my favorite pieces is Gustav Holst's The Planets. That's something my mother introduced me to a long time ago. And I've been to maybe 3 or 4 performances of it. And I decided my favorite movement of the planets is Saturn. And I learned after doing some research on it that it's Holst's favorite movement too, which I thought was interesting. He calls it the bringer of old age. And if anyone can tell me why it brings old age, I'd like to know. But I think I love it because there's this one part at the end that just takes me to a different place. And it's maybe 3 seconds. And I don't know which recording we're doing, so I can't tell you where it is. But it starts out really ethereal. And you kind of feel like you're floating for the longest time and you zone out and you lose track of where you are. And then there's this moment where the key changes and it's just bliss for me. So.
Good late night headphone music.
That's right. I hope you enjoy it too. For Friday Favorites, I'm Laura Durham from Salt Lake City, and this is The Planets by Gustav Holst.